get respect up on the street. Boom. Roasted.
What's up guys, Sal here. So when Samsung hyped the Galaxy Note 9 as a terabyte ready phone, you still needed a 512GB of microSD card slot to achieve it. But today Samsung has officially unveiled the world's first 1TB flash storage solution for phone manufacturers that will make sure that you don't need to spring for an extra SD card slot to achieve that terabyte storage. This chip will allow smartphones to have internal storage similar to that of laptops. It's a well-known fact that flash drives are faster than microSD cards. To give you an accurate number, they are 10 times faster than the microSD cards, according to Samsung. A lot of you would say, we don't need such storage space, it's just overkill. Yes, to a lot of us, 1TB storage is way too much, but Netflix downloaders might disagree. People who film a lot of 4K videos also might disagree. The phone cameras are getting better each year. Companies are also using a ridiculous amount of megapixels for their cameras. These all add up, and when you think about it, 1TB of storage might not seem ridiculous. Another important reason why I think it isn't an overkill is the augmented reality. Companies like Samsung and Apple are hyping AR as the next big thing. And AR or even VR apps require a storage capacity beyond what is deemed as necessary in today's flagships. Those who have virtual reality headsets can relate that these VR apps or games take a ridiculous amount of space. So yeah, right now it may seem too much, but it's wise to be prepared for future advancement in these fields. That said, when we're gonna see this in phones? It's totally possible that the Galaxy S10 might come with this chip. There were multiple rumors in the past suggesting it, so you can count on the Galaxy S10 to feature a terabyte of internal storage. So this shouldn't come off as a surprise to anyone. Samsung has been the top dog for years now, and they retained the spot in 2018 as well. If we compare the figures of fourth quarter of 2018, you can see Apple at the top, which was expected because of the launch of the new iPhones in that quarter. But if we compare the whole 2018 numbers, then Samsung firmly sits at the top. You can see that Huawei is growing rapidly with an increase of 34% year over year due to their aggressive products and pricing. Samsung does acknowledge this, and they have changed their mobile strategy recently, which includes releasing more meaningful budget and mid-range phones with a lower price tag and not holding back their flagships. It will be interesting to see if this makes a substantial difference to their market share. Of course, that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.